historian Ptolemaeus knows this city, but Redava. The famous Ukrainian writer Lesya Ukrainka is nowhere on the stone, and contemporaries call it the Tomb of Podolia. Nowadays, Kamyanets-Podilskyi is the National Historical Architectural Preserve, one of the seven wonders and the third city in Ukraine according to the quantity of the historical monuments in one square meter.
The nature created all the opportunities for the development of the city. The city fortress.
The rocky peninsula, surrounded by the high canyon of the Smotrich River, always attracted people of different cultures and nations. These lands were inhabited since the culture of Prefilia. Mainly the ancient Romans built the first settlement and the fortress bridge.
In Kiev Rus there was the first settlement and the wooden castle. In the 14th century, Kamyanets became the capital of Podolia. Later, during the Polish rule, it became the main boundary, city fortress and the invincible stronghold of the castle of Europe.
The water system of the Ukrainian and the Polish gates, the military towers around the peninsula, the high canyon of the Smotrich River, the old and the new fortresses, all these military buildings did Kamyanets invincible. Once the brave Ottoman Sultan Osman II was very surprised and asked the locals, who built this fortress?
God built it, was the answer.
Thanks the will of the Lord, the city was built on the rock where there was no water.
Once the Armenian merchant decided to lay a water supply system, but only the well was dark in the center and the water was too salty and unfit for drinking.
The water was brought from the springs near the city.
The three nations dominated there: the Ukrainians, Rusina, the Poles, and the Armenian. The Polish market square with the city hall was the central place for the yarmulkes. And nowadays it's the place where the different events and festivals are held.
In the Polish times, Kamyanets-Podilskyi was the column of the Catholicism.
Franciscans, Jesuits, Carmelites, Dominicans lived in the city.
Every friary had own profession and duties.
First, the Dominican friars came to the city.
Their church of Saint Nicholas was built on the highest top of the peninsula. Later, the noble family of the Podolskys took care of this friary. That's why the Podolskyi's house and symbol are seen. The triumphal arch, built to honor the last Polish king, Stanisław Augustus Poniatowski, is famous among locals as a special place where you can make a wish. It is the main gate to the Rome Catholic Peter and Paul's Cathedral.
The first wooden church was built in the 14th century by the Ukrainian-Lithuanian Duke Skoriatovichis. Later, the Polish community built the stone church.
When the Ottomans came in 1672, the cathedral was reconsecrated into the main Muslim mosque.
Returning the city back to Poland, the Ottoman Empire asked to save the highest minaret due to the peace agreement. Soon the Polish community established the Virgin Mary on the top of the minaret. More than 250 years we have the unique combination of the two world religions, Christianity and Islam, the Virgin Mary on the minaret.
Visited the Rome Catholic Peter and Paul's Cathedral, you can see the altar of the 18th century, one of the oldest in Ukraine working organ with hand keyboard. A few chapels, original old icons, frescoes, glass windows, and the marble miracle of Laura. It is the great monument of the girl from the noble Polish family Szczesnecki, who tragically died at age of 91.
The last built church in the peninsula was the St. Trinity Church. The Trinitarian friars ransomed Christian slaves from the captivity. There were 30 Christian churches on the maps of the beginning of the 17th century.
The Ukrainian churches dominated, but only the Church of St. Peter and Paul survived among the stone ones.
It represents the sacral defense architecture of the 15th to 16th centuries.
The legend tells that the Ukrainian hetman Sahaidachny, returning from the Khotyn War, thought how majestic the rocks supported the fortress in Kamyanets-Podilskyi. It would be a good idea to believe in the Lord too.
The only one saved wooden church of the St. Cross is an example of the unique wooden architecture.
Of the Christian churches and the historic center during the Second World War spoiled the ancient Kamyanets-Podilskyi.
The Church of Saint Trinity,
and St. Alexander Nevsky's Cathedral
were rebuilt in the 21st century.
A few streets deeper Kamyanets-Podilskyi from the other city. The houses here were built one or two stories up and one or two stories down.
The modern luxury hotels are built in such a way.
The streets were named, but the houses had no numbers. That's why the beautiful symbols and ornaments were used.
And Kamyanets in Podolia has its oven house with chimeras, the former house of the Ukrainian magistrate. All over the world, Armenians and Jews live. The first Armenians were invited to Kiev Rus as the military men.
Escaping from the wars in native Armenia, the Armenian merchants and craftsmasters came to Kamyanets. It became one of the most favorite cities for Armenians.
We can see the palace of the Armenian bishop, the high Armenian bell tower, the ruins of St. Nicholas Church. The oldest stone church of the St. Nicholas. The narrow streets with the old houses and cobblestone.
In the Polish times, Jews were forbidden to live in big cities. They came to live in Kamyanets-Podilskyi during the reign of the Ottoman and the Russian empires.
Up to the end of the 19th century, the quantity of Jews was about 30%. They had about 20 synagogues and lived in the center of the city. After the Holocaust and assimilation, only the former synagogue and a few cemeteries remember about the Guards folk. Generally, the Muslim minaret is seen very well, but not everyone knows that the mother of Mehmed IV, who conquered Kamyanets, was Ukrainian, born not far away from here. It's not famous, but there is the Muslim minbar, an embona for preaching in the Dominican church. Walking the narrow streets, you can get to the Halil Pasha's house and hammam.
Not everyone walked to the waterfall. It was cut in the rock by the Ottomans who besieged the city in the 17th century.
there is the Turkish military wall and the other historic buildings and towers.
After the second division of Poland, Kamyanets-Podilskyi was included to the Russian Empire. Once the famous Russian king Peter the Great visited the city. His head flew away from the wind. "Oh, how windy the tower is," said the Russian Tsar. And that's why one of the military towers is called the Windy Gate.
But nowadays you can see no people on the former Tsar's road.
After the Russian Revolution, Kamyanets-Podilskyi was the temporary capital of the Ukrainian National Republic.
150 years ago, the new city was built. The historic center was called the Old City, and the new planned bridge was built to the administrative center. This bridge as if connects the past and the nowadays.
All year round, you are welcome to Kamyanets-Podilskyi. You can participate in walking tours and bus tours for individual tourists and groups, in theater medieval performance hunting for riches, and cognitive quests for kids and adults. Museum of the old fortress, of the mini castles of Ukraine, of money, of the city rights, the archaeological museum, the picture gallery. Trip on armored military vehicles, electric shuttle buses, retro cars, etc. around the city. Flying on air balloons and mini planes. Rope jumping, trolley, rock climbing. Making goods at pottery with your hands, buying souvenirs at the souvenir bus, enjoying time at quiet cafes and restaurants. Kamyanets-Podilskyi is wonderful and picturesque in spring, in summer, in autumn, in winter, in the sunny day, under the rain, in the night, during the festival, in primal silence.
Have rest in Kamyanets-Podilskyi means to visit the architectural monuments and to enjoy the nature at the same time. Only if the city is visited by you, it becomes alive as if in the past.